all of you for doing a good job. And basically doing or conducting interview of almost 1800 odd interns, those who have applied. I have been told that out of that 1800 are selected, and only say about 70-80 people are there at the moment in our conversation. Am I properly audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. So I would like that I will limit my conversation only few minutes, and then I would like that let it be properly organized so that we can have a smooth conduct of business. I have been told that we have selected 800 interns, so we can group them in 8 group or whatever, and we can have group them subject wise, and we can have deliberation for each subject. Today my interaction will be limited to only few minutes. I would like to brief our interns. First of all, I would like to congratulate my team, which has undertaken such a elaborate interview process and selecting meritorious interns who can really contribute for the nation. Hello,
sir.
Yeah, they should really mute themselves, and only when they are desirous to speak, they should unmute themselves. That is a very important, and there should be some internal code of discipline. So once again, I would like to congratulate my team. I would like to congratulate interns, and today I would like to just brief that crime-free Bharat. It is a great concept with a determination to transform the face and fate of our country. It is not a normal internship. Internship is a methodology to select the virtuous student and take this journey and make enabling them to contribute in various module, making use of the 21 technology to make our nation crime free. This is very important at the backdrop when Supreme Court is giving or expressing helplessness over the criminalization of our politics. I would like to tell our interns that as per the admission of our member of parliament, 42% of them, they have admitted they are having criminal record against themselves. 29% of them, they are having very, very serious offenses of the murder and rape, etc. When the politics is getting hand in glove with the criminals, earlier criminals supporting politics or politician, now criminals themselves are becoming politicians, they are becoming lawmakers. It is a very, very grave situation for the nation. And in such situation, dreaming crime-free Bharat with 5 certainty is a great task, it's a great vision. I will take 10 minutes to really elaborate on the concept of crime-free Bharat. Crime-free Bharat is having 5 certainties. The first certainty is, which we have very close to, and we have completed the module, that is having technology through the various channels and platform where we can provide the facility to our citizen and they can lodge their FIR without visiting Thana. And when we talk of this kind of thing, sometime I will elaborate in detail. It has to be technology driven, and it has to be technology has to be enabling things. Because when we are talking of reporting a FIR in Thana, I do not mean our interns. I do not really mean the people, those who understand technology. I really do not mean that people, those who are having smartphones. So whether our efforts would be helping people, those who are illiterate, they may not be having resources, they may not be owning a smartphone, whether our technology can help them to register their FIR without visiting Thana. And so that will require the mix of technology and mix of human interface. The technology will make it possible that the person can express the desire that they want to launch FIR, and our volunteer may reach and will be capturing audio, video, and other evidences, and would be making that a fully legally admissible FIR. And that FIR should have all four attributes. It means audio, video content of a complaint. It should make out that all attributes of a crime, they have been captured. Proper sections and of the particular acts that has been applied to. So if you could capture the content of FIR, if you could apply the sections along with the act, we have completed two attributes. Then third attribute is facility, whereby signature of the complainant would be captured. And then the fourth, that it has to be routed to police officer, that is station house officer. And once he puts his signature, then only it will become legally acceptable FIR. Now, when people don't want to register an FIR, people want to take application on paper, which will never be converted into an FIR. The willingness and participation of the SHO to sign, it will require great host of the mix of the four strategy, which will virtually force not only the police officer, but on their senior officers, but it will force the government at large to fulfill its constitutional obligation of the policing under entry 2, schedule 7 of our constitution. So it is a great thing where the technology playing a pivotal role with the participation of the stakeholders. And when we talk of the stakeholders, I include whole population. I am talking of stakeholders, that is 137 crore people of our country. It is a great subject. Sometime I will be talking to interns on various subject which may not be directly connected with their internship, but they will be more connected with the, I will say, they are more connected with the concept of the crime-free Bharat. And crime-free Bharat is having five certainties. And these certainties are supported with 21 technology, and there are five revenue streams which will be flowing to the citizens. And if that whole concept could be implemented as it is envisaged, probably per capita income would be increasing by 3 times and GDP may grow by 5 times. We can dream of taking 3 trillion economy to 15 trillion economy with minimum investment from government side. So the concept is very powerful. Now, the whole world, it is being dominated by the soft power of Indians. A time has come that soft power at the student level should also really calibrate itself and convert in a real power we should empower citizens. So the interns must understand that it is just not question of helping the people, helping the citizens so that they can have five certainties, but it is question of gifting a kind of a system to ourselves where we can claim all these things as matter of right. We need not to visit any politician, we need not to visit any bureaucrats for getting these five certainties. So the first certainty, as I said, it is a registration of FIR. Second certainty is the certainty of detection. And the certainty of detection, not because of capability of the police, but it is because of the capability of the police, capability of the forensic scientist, and capacity of the backend engine, which is supported by 21 technologies. This backend engine would be in position to get almost all offenses detected, irrespective of the fact that the police officer who is investigating the case, he may not be a very big person, so an ordinary police officer or an ordinary investigating officer should be in position to detect all offenses, and not only detect all offenses, but collect infallible evidences duly supported with the three certificates, that is the certificate of admissibility. So no lawyer should be in position to question its admissibility in the court of law. It will be having chain of integrity, hence nobody will be in position to question its integrity in the court of law. And the same thing is about the chain of custody, that is more so for the physical object. Then we move from detection and certainty of detection to the certainty of conviction. And when we talk of the certainty of conviction, we are talking at the same breath as we said in the first, that there will be FIR without visiting to the thana. Now we are talking that there will be court trial without visiting court. So that would be happening through the video-based court trial system, though there will be all participants. So judge would be there. A personal assistant to the judge would also be there. There will be prosecution lawyer, there will be defense lawyer, and the one channel would be dedicated for evidences, for the documents, they will be displayed. And the backend engine would be in position to give the right respect to his witness. At present, the witness, those who are contributing a lot, they have been not getting to the kind of the respect the system should give to them. So we can even factor in the convenience of our witness. We would be in position to first identify the identity of the witness. We would be in position to even identify, making use of the technology, that he is not under any duress or fear. And then finally, there would be his deposition of his statement. And there may be n number of the cameras which might be kept, or sensors which, or IoT devices which might be capturing, not only what is he saying, how he is saying, and what is his physical condition. So if he is perspiring, the technology will not only capture that he is perspiring, but probably somewhere there will be a note that, hey, just please pay attention, he is perspiring. His legs are shaking. Probably these dimensions which are being missed at the moment, we would be in position to capture that. We would be in position to support judges about the facts, about the laws, about the verdicts and jurisprudence which has not been brought on record by the prosecutor or by the defense lawyer. So there will not be only the two, there will be the third support system to the judges that will be flowing from the backend engine of crime-free Bharat. So the court trial system will be highly transparent, it will be highly efficient, And unless we talk about the pendency of 3.19 crore cases before the court of law, so crime-free Bharat feels that we have to have the strategy whereby we should be in position to resolve these 3.19 crore cases which are pending before the court of law. Now, this has to be done making use of the judicious mix of the technology and coming out-of-box solution. So, there is a capacity which one judge may or one magistrate may take a case. So, basically, we can go for augmenting the number of magistrate, and that magistrate need not to be from the judicial field. They may be the other people, those who could be given a 15 or 20 day training or a month training. They can be, we can take their examination and we can notify them as a magistrate. And there may be the specialist magistrate, those who are having a special knowledge of a subject. So probably they will be in better, they will be knowing law. They will be knowing the various intricacies of the law. At the same time, they are the wizard of their own subject. Probably they are in better position to deliberate and deliver and pronounce judgment as an expert in that field. So we will not be in position to even, we will not only be dissolving these 3.19 crore cases, but the pronouncement of the judgment would also be superior. And it will not be a burden on the government, because the judges, so-called additional judges or ad hoc judges, those who will be nominated, they will be getting remuneration as per their contribution number of the cases they are handling. So they will not be on payroll. So, and that will be additional incentive for the judges to really discharge more number of the cases, handle more number of the cases. Probably within 2 years, we would should be in position to dissolve 3.19 crore cases. And in future, within 3 to 6 months, we should be in position to decide case with certainty. And when we said decide case, it should take care of judgment at the lower court, district courts, and high court and Supreme Court. It means things would be happening almost round the clock, 24/7, and probably the hearing should be completed in 3 days or 4 days, that kind of the things. The judgment should come within a week so that the appeal and other things could be handled. And we say it is not the certainty of the conviction, we will say certainty of justice. So if a wrong case has been really, or somebody has been wrongly charged, then it should be a certainty of acquittal, because it is essentially a false case. So we should not be keen unnecessarily convicting a person if he is not really guilty of it. And since it will be, things will be happening in a much more transparent and powerful way with a lot of evidence which cannot be manipulated, I feel that delivery of the justice would be a possibility. So crime-free Bharat envisages, with the use of the technology and participation of all 3,137 crore stakeholders, to give the certainty as a certainty of justice. And since all the criminals, those who are on radar, they will be monitored through volunteers. That is, when we talk the volunteers, the whole population will be the volunteer. And 137 crore people, in one way or other, they would be volunteers. And criminals, criminal culture, they will be having all around. So not only human eye to observe, but they will be having CCTVs, IoT devices. And probably their presence, not only their presence will be captured, what they are bearing, what they are purchasing, what is their mood, with whom they are moving, whether they are armed with weapons. Technology would be in position to predict that, and probably with certainty would be in position to prevent them even before he could commit the crime. So the fourth is the certainty of prevention. And the fifth is, when you know everything about them, what they are wearing, what they are talking, what is their expression. So face expression, gait expression, this expression, and everything would be would be available, captured, and it will be available in database. And if we even give a small portion of even his activity, technology, backend technology would be in position to, with a greater certainty and greater probability, that this is the person who really is there. So image is not proper, image is blurred. These things will not come into the, things, because we will be having a larger database with the larger coverage, and we would be in position to prevent the crime with certainty. Now, matter comes that if we know criminals, they are on our radar, we are capturing micro details, then why they should we should allow them to continue to be criminal? So there comes the fifth certainty. The certainty is of certainty of rehabilitation of criminals. So Crime Free Bharat envisages our volunteer expert with the psychological things. They would be reaching out to these criminals. They will capture the whole profile of that person of that criminal, will identify their good point, identify the deficiency, and probably will come out a rehabilitative strategies where that criminal will become a resource and a good resource and a good citizen for the country. And that's how, because it is not by the certainty of reporting, certainty of detection, certainty of conviction, and certainty of prevention. Because if our stomach is still empty, you have to appreciate that person will be committing crime to go to jail because his stomach is empty. For him, survival is more important. So with this, there are five certainty, and when any system would be having these many details, natural question will arise that what about the privacy to the citizen? So Crime Free Bharat has Crime Free Bharat through its automated investigation support system with 21 technology. It is a national police mission which is functioning under BP and R&D, and I am the project leader of that mission. And in the month of the September 22, I have submitted one draft legislation to BPRND and to the Government of India through BPRND, and which envisages that we would be guaranteeing the right to the privacy. And the data which will be being captured by Crime Free Bharat, it will be in the custody of the National Authority for the Scientific and Technical Assistance in Investigation and Detection of Crime, properly enacted as per the original responsibility of Government of India under Entry 65C, and as a responsibility of the state government under Entry 2, Schedule 7, List 2. So we will have a proper legal apparatus which will be backing this system. Now, Crime Free Bharat is also envisaging a very, not only that Crime Free Bharat, but a healthy, wealthy Bharat. And the wealth will be flowing to each and every citizen, each and every stakeholders. So they will be getting five revenue streams. The first revenue stream will be coming from their participation and information, which they will be pushing to the system. They will get the revenue stream for that. Summons, warrant, and other processes, they will be executed through public and stakeholders, through the volunteers, and they will be getting revenue stream for doing this service. Then all experts, whether they are the electronic experts, cyber experts, forensic experts, legal experts, financial experts, these experts they would be in position, they will be participating in providing very specialized services for investigation and detection, and for that service they will be getting a revenue stream. And the fourth and more important stream, when that depending upon your previous task, your grading and your location, you may be given a task to do certain kind of the activity to verify about a criminal or to do something, and one revenue stream will also be flowing for that. And fifth revenue stream, which is the most important revenue stream, that Crime Free Bharat envisages to help you in whatever you are doing. So the revenue which will be flowing from your NIS activity, that will become the fifth revenue stream. So Crime Free Bharat, with its five certainties, that is the reporting, detection, conviction, prevention and rehabilitation, and with these five certainties, five revenue streams, which are capable of capturing all deviation.
Sorry to disturb you, sir. अभी खत्म होने वाला है session. अगर खत्म हो जाएगा तो reconnect हो जाएगा सभी.
Okay, fine. So basically, I wanted my intern to understand that they are not doing some kind of a very small thing, but they are something they should be associated with the for the longer kind of activity. I request them that they should have the dream to continue to work with the Crime Free Bharat as a internship level 1, internship level 2, internship level 3, because.